guys, what's up? Thank you so much for watching Circuit Bazaar. So today we are going to discuss the solar panel based fridge system using Peltier plate. So now I am going to explain the complete project. So these are the battery, these are the bike battery. So we are using double battery because Peltier plate need high amount of power. I mean, current consumption of Peltier plate is very high, and there are dual Peltier plate inside this box. So we have used this large size heat sink because heat generated by the Peltier plate is very high, and to dissipate that heat in the environment you need this much size of heat sink, and to dissipate heat from this heat sink you need this fan as well, which will throw cool air on this heat sink, and heat will be dissipated in the environment. And these are the two battery which are in parallel. These two battery will provide power to the Peltier plate and to the fan. So these are the two fan. This is the arrangement of only dissipating heat in the environment. So for the cooling system there is another heat sink inside and another fan. I'll show you that thing later. And this is the toggle switch. This is the high power toggle switch which will own the power supply of the complete fridge system or cooler system, right? This is the solar panel. The solar panel will charge the battery. Okay, and if you manually charge the battery, if the battery will get discharged, then you can charge from here. Like this is the positive terminal, so you can apply positive point here, and this is the negative terminal because black wire is negative. You can apply negative point here, means if you want to manually charge the battery, because power consumption of this Peltier plate is very high. And this is the glass wool. This glass wool insulate the inside environment from the outer environment, right? And this is the temperature display unit. Right now temperature on the display unit is 23.1 degree Celsius. This temperature will decrease if I own the system. So I wanna show you something inside of this box as well, which will create the cooling effect. This is the arrangement. There is a heat sink, and then there is a fan as well, and there is a temperature sensor. This is where the wire of the temperature sensor. This fan will throw the cool air, and this temperature sensor will monitor the temperature inside the box. If temperature will increase or decrease, that will be shown on the outside display, right? So this is the arrangement, and this box won't allow the cool effect to go outside, so that it can keep the things cool inside the box. So now I am going to show you the working of this project. So to show the working of this project, I'll own the system. So if I'll own this toggle switch, now you can see that fan is on, and temperature right now is 23.1 degree Celsius. This fan is also on, and the fan inside of this box is also on. And you can see that after some time the reading should be start decreasing, because temperature will keep on going down. 22.6 degree Celsius. You have to wait for some time, temperature will keep on decreasing. And temperature, this is the temperature sensor wire, 21.3 degree Celsius temperature now. So the temperature will keep on going down. 18.6 degree Celsius temperature right now, 17.3 degree Celsius temperature right now. And if you will see inside the box, then there is another fan is also running, which is providing cool air, right? Another fan is also running. Now temperature becomes 16.2 degree Celsius. So the cooling effect is very fast. This much amount of cooling effect means so fast cooling effect you can't get through AC as well. The minimum temperature set by AC is also 16 degrees Celsius, but you can see that from 23 degrees Celsius to 15.4 degrees Celsius in such a small amount of time. Right now temperature is 14.7 degrees Celsius. So this is the working of this Peltier plate, and if you will touch these heat sink, they are getting heat. You can feel that heat from these as well. So you may ask the question why we have used so much amount of big size heat sink on outer side and small heat sink in inner side. So answer is simple, because heat generated by Peltier plate is very high. Means if you provide 12 volt power supply to the Peltier plate, it can't hold itself without heat sink. It will burn out. Now you can see the temperature 12.9 degrees Celsius. So I'm gonna off the power supply, right? Because power consumption of this Peltier plate is very high. So this is all about this Peltier plate based fridge system. So right now temperature is 12.4 degrees Celsius. So this is the minimum temperature we have achieved in such a small amount of time. So So this is the working of all this peltier plate system. Now temperature 11.9 degrees Celsius, right? Take it.